Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Drew, product manager on the SQL team. Drew, thanks so much for coming on back on Data Exposed.
Thanks for having me back.
Always a pleasure. And today, we're going to be talking about source control for SQL database in Fabric, and source control is no new topic for you or this audience. But I want you to kind of kick us off by telling us a little bit about the scenario that developers are in and why this might be appealing.
Yeah, for developers, source control is part of their usual process. You check your code in, then you're able to track the changes and see what files have been modified, as well as when you're working by yourself and you want to do multiple tasks at once, or if you're working in a team, even better, you're going to want to use branches where different people, they can keep their changes separate until they're ready to merge them together or combine them. But for databases, it can be a little tricky. Maybe you're sharing a development database. Maybe you have trouble tracking what's changing on the database in addition to your application code. Mm-hmm. So it's an exciting time for SQL Database and Fabric to be getting source control functionality for the database.
Cool. Okay, so tell us a little bit more about what that entails.
Yeah, so with SQL Database and Fabric, being able to use the source control integration means that the Fabric platform is going to track what objects have changed in the database, allowing you to check those into source control as the definition of MySQL table, MySQL stored procedures. This is not just a one direction thing where you're checking in, hey, I've made these changes to the database, but if you have changes in source control that you want to bring to the databases that you have, one or many, mm-hmm. you can update out of source control to the database.
Okay, awesome. Cool. So it really helps you in the full cycle of development.
Yeah. You're not just headed in one direction and getting stuck that way.
Yeah.
You can kind of have any development process you want just around Fabric.
Cool. Well, I know you've prepared some scenarios for us to take a look at. I'd love to see it.
So in my spare time, occasionally I do a little bit of development, and I was working on a web app that I've been building in Django. And Django, being a Python ORM, allows me to write Python code models that define my objects, my database. So I'm not actually writing SQL code, which in my spare time seems kind of weird as a PM in SQL, but it speeds up the development process. And as I was building this app and then using SQL Database and Fabric for the database of it, I was able to use the source control integration to kind of speed up how I'm tracking my database changes. Why I'm doing this, even though I wanted to, you know, use an ORM and have that efficiency up front, is I know when my app is ready and, you know, my database developers, my DBAs are getting ready to do deployments of it, they're going to be asking me tough questions like, what did you have for breakfast? Or what are the database changes? Uh-huh. So I need to have something for them that's not just, look, I wrote this Python,
right? But
this is my database code. This is what needs to happen. So I went ahead and I connected my Fabric workspace to a source control Git repository. I did some recordings of my setup process and the development steps that I went through because I wanted to be able to share them with everyone here on the show. I was able to connect that Git repository right to the workspace by selecting the repository in Azure DevOps and then hitting that connect and sync. I used Azure DevOps, but I could also use GitHub.
Nice. So
depending on kind of where my team is working, I'm able to use that source control repository. The code that gets checked in for the SQL database is a SQL project.
Nice.
You know how I feel about SQL projects.
Oh, yeah.
So with that SQL project checked into source control, now I'm able to follow the database changes as I make them. When you use an ORM, you generally perform migrations. You're in the tool itself, whether it's EF Core or Django, mm-hmm. and you can use those command line tools to run the migrations. So when I do this for this prototype polls mm-hmm. app, mm-hmm. it's going to create database objects, but I don't necessarily know exactly what it's doing, but I can use Fabric to track that.
Interesting.
So I've applied the migrations here, and when I go into the database in Fabric, I can see all the tables that it's created. These tables have different definitions. There's choice and question for the polls, and the source control panel in Fabric is really simple or quick, even, for me to use to check these changes into source control. I'm comfortable checking my app code into source control, VS Code, Visual Studio, wherever I am. But now for my database changes, I can just use my web browser in my Fabric workspace to commit those changes into source control. It takes a few minutes because it's using that SQL project to write all the objects out to different SQL files. When I get a SQL project with all these SQL files, I can do a lot of things with it, but even just without having to learn anything new, I'm able to use the Azure DevOps tools or the GitHub tools to see, hey, these were the table definitions that were written for polls choice and polls question. Those are two models that I wrote. I defined them as Python, but now I have the answers.
That's very cool.
To the questions that were asked by my database administrators or DB developers. And that kind of gives me that setup into how do I commit my database and track it over time in source control.
Okay, so just to make sure I got it. So you're building your app in Django. You're just writing Python code. Mm-hmm. And then by leveraging Fabric and SQL projects, when you start to check this into source control, it's taking care of all the, you know, what we know about source control and SQL projects. It's taking all that and generating code that if you wanted to, you could now, you know, use this to apply to a new database or a developer database or something like that.
Exactly. Exactly. So I'm able to hand these SQL projects off to other people, whether they're going to deploy to other databases in Fabric or they want to instantiate developer instances. If I were to potentially want to start working on a specific feature, right now I have polls choice and polls question. The second table down there, it has a space for question text and the date that that question gets published. But maybe I want to add like whether or not it's a multiple select option mm-hmm. or if I want to highlight a question. I'm going to work on those two features for a while. If I'm going to go off on a tangent, mm-hmm. I'm going to use a branch. And that same concept exists in Fabric. For Fabric, I can use the branches capability in source control to branch out to a new workspace. This is going to do two things. It's going to create a source control, a Git branch, but it's also going to create another workspace. So I'm naming the branch. I use Django app feature because I'm very creative sometimes. And then I'm going to name the workspace did exposed. The first one has no number on the end. The second workspace has two on the end. And that's really important because it's empty here for just a second. But as I work on my feature, I want to be able to test it. Right. I want to be able to connect my app to it and see what's happening. Thankfully, Fabric's just not creating a new workspace. It's going to deploy all the objects that are checked into source control.
All the objects.
All the objects. Hmm. So the database, the analytical mirror there, I'm getting all of those components and then the objects inside the database.
Wow.
So I don't have to run migrations again. I don't need to guess what tables need to be created right. and all that. The source control already knows, and Fabric's going to deploy all those objects for me. So once I go into the database that gets spun up, I'm in my second workspace. I'm mm-hmm. in my development or my feature workspace. But now I have all those tables ready for me. And I can keep developing. I can go ahead and make those changes to the model. So this is the Python code that I was working on for my little proof of concept. Uh-huh. And I've added those two fields. I'm on my application development feature branch, and I am going to be able to treat my database the same way, which is just this phenomenal, exciting thing for me to know. I can develop, I can make changes to my database. I'm not worried about messing up the primary one that other people are working on. But what gets even better is okay. that I don't have to worry about combining these changes when I'm done.
Oh.
Fabric has that last step for me. Because if I apply these migrations to my workspace, to my development mm-hmm. instance, I'm then able to bring it all the way back around. So I'm in my second workspace, we're going to do the same process we've done already where we're checking this into source control, but we're on a branch. And this is like the 15-second pop quiz for everyone at home. When you have a feature branch and you're done with it, you merge it back together.
Right.
That's how you finish it out. So once I've committed this in, I'm going to be able to go use that same process that I usually do to merge my changes together. The way that SQL projects are written are completely declarative. I'm not trying to track any alter table, add column statements. Not only do those take me very long, embarrassingly long to write sometimes, but you can't combine those easily. Because these are all declarative, the change set that I'm getting is just a two-line add for the two columns in the table. And then with that two-line add, I'm able to create a pull request between my feature branch and then that primary branch mm-hmm. that we started on to mm-hmm. smash the changes together and get a single database model. So I'm going to complete this pull request, which combines the changes into that main branch. When I complete that merge, I'm done with the feature branch. Maybe I'm done working on the feature, or maybe I want to take it another direction. But where it gets really great is if I go back to my first workspace. Mm-hmm. Let's say I want to figure out what my next set of changes are going to be, or another group of people want to review and check through it. Fabric's letting me know that I have pending updates in that branch. And those pending updates can be applied to the database automatically.
Wow.
Fabric's calculating for, based on that SQL project and source control, what changes it needs to make to make the databases match. So before the update finishes, real quickly, I just grabbed the table definition where it doesn't have those two new columns in it. So this is just me my before update script. And then that'll allow us to see that the update actually right. finished. The source control, again, like so important, doesn't have any kind of alter table statements checked into it. All of that is calculated behind the scenes by Fabric looking at what the database looks like and then what the source control looks like and figuring out what that deployment plan needs to be. After the update went through, I have those two new columns added to my table. So I can kind of really quickly compare and contrast, is highlighted in multiple choice, got added to my database in just a really quick demo. And that's all based on that change in that pull request.
Wow, that's awesome. This really brings it all full circle for folks.
Yeah, like as a developer, being able to quickly work through multiple branches, not just in my app code, but also with my database, completely changes the situation you're in as a developer, where I don't want to have to figure out which changes need to come in when. I can point to, I have a pull request, these are the database changes that need to be made, and follow through with that. That really means that I can take my development, whether it's ORM based or model first, and run right through with it with SQL Database and Fabric.
Amazing. That's awesome, Drew. Thanks so much for sharing that with us. One final question for you. Any tips or tricks or words of advice for folks who maybe are getting started with this for the first time?
Yeah, in Fabric, I would start with just committing my database to source control. As you're working on it, if you don't find a natural point in development to do it, just go ahead and at the end of the day when you're about done with work, go ahead and commit your database to source control, and you'll start to see as the history of changes build up over time, the value that you get out of that 30-second step of committing to source yeah. control once a day is really going to pay off. For those people that really like to automate things, you can mm-hmm. use the Fabric REST APIs to automate periodically running commit to source control. If you have other people making changes to a database and you really want to make sure that things get committed, you can use those Fabric REST APIs to try that out too.
Amazing. Cool. Great tips. I'm glad you had to.
Thank you. Folks,
if you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment. We'll put some links in the description for you to learn more. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.